You wanted the Mornington Pier dive, so we got it, man.
Yeah, the visibility is quite good.
Visibility is great.
Yeah.
It was built originally, and they added an L shape onto it, which went out that way. So the pier, when you come down here, it'll be pretty obvious. It goes straight out, but there was also an L shape that went all the way out. That they used to use for their steamer ships to go into.
All the ships used to come in here.
Yeah, really big ships. So I'm not exactly sure why they needed that L shape. I guess they couldn't pull up easily in here. Maybe they're not as maneuverable.
But definitely trickier from the other piers, I'd say. And today I'm using my twins for the very first time.
So first time, yeah. Twins. So let's do it.
It'll be interesting to see.
And yeah, first time dry suit. So this is
you.
Gonna be, yeah, this is gonna be quite fun. It could be very funny. Could be very funny. I think it'll be okay.
Yeah, it'll be fine. You've used it before in the training, right?
Used it before.
Yeah, so you'll be okay.
A funny thing about this place is I remember one of the times we went here, I was going along with my camera, and all of a sudden a fishing line came down.
Oh, yes.
And it literally grabbed onto my camera, yeah. And I'm like, I don't want to let go of one hand and grab my knife because I'm thinking the fisherman might just pull it up. And you were just close to me and you're like, I got my knife.
Cut it.
But,
yeah. That was the only opportunity or the first opportunity I had to use that knife for many years.
It's funny, isn't it? Like you bring a knife on your dives every time and you kind of assume that it's something you would pull out all the time, but actually, hardly ever.
No.
But it was that time, I could see your eyes lit up.
Yeah,
when the fishing line was there, you're like, right, I've got the tool for this.
Yeah, so there's the time to shine. Use this knife for the
this
very first
is
time.
Yeah.
No, it was all fun. All right, let's do it.
Yeah, let's do it, man. Sweet.
Sweet.
Thank you.
pretty good dive, good conditions. Visibility was better than other times I've dove in here.
So here, we have had like quite a lot of rain recently, and I was a bit concerned, you know, maybe the visibility would be shot because of the rain. But actually, the rain didn't impact it. I think the light winds really helped us today, and the visibility here wasn't as good as I've seen it.
Oh, you have seen it better?
A little bit, but it was still pretty good.
Yeah, it was not bad.
But yeah, here is a prime location for getting lost. I don't know what it is. I think everything's sort of not quite straight, and it all just sort of moves around.
It's okay, just follow your training if you get lost.
It was quite funny when we jumped in and went down near the doorway. Like, I came down and immediately saw like a seahorse right in front of us on that matting. I was like, what? I couldn't believe. lots of fishing line, lots more I think than I've seen for a while. Next time, definitely have to bring something to wind it up and clean up a bit.
Surveyed some stuff from the bottom today as well. Got to cut the line on the pier again today.
Yes, saved me.
I don't think it was all over.
I was like, I'm gonna drown here because I've got this fishing line on me.
Right.
Oops, saved my life.
Did I?
Yes.
Oh. Well, you can thank me. Nah. It was just a line I saw at him. It was like, let's cut this off.
Yeah.
But yeah, seeing all those stingrays, they were stingrays, the smaller ones?
They were stingarees. So I did some research on them, so the stingarees have got a tail fin. You'll see on the video, like it's got an actual fin on it.
Yeah.
Whereas the stingarees are part of the same family as stingrays, so it's a type of stingray.
Yeah. Yeah, the tail was a bit different of this one, right?
Yeah, I think this one had some bugs or something on it, and I was like, I don't know if we should, like, you don't want to touch them.
No.
Because, yeah, stingrays obviously have got a barb on them. It didn't look like it was having much fun.
Did you see that, I don't know what kind of fish was it, like the stingray that was just under that block and there was something in front of it and it was pointing towards it?
Yeah, I got some video of that.
Very well camouflaged.
Yeah, I didn't even see it. And you saw there was two fish under there, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. I noticed the eyes. That's what revealed it. You know, through the tunnel as I came out, there was that, what do you call that? I think puffer fish, right? There was that big puffer fish as I came out, and I was like, whoa.
It was a toadfish. Yeah,
toadfish, right. Yes.
So the difference is the globefish or puffer fish have spines on their outside.
Right.
Whereas the toadfish are smooth.
Smooth, yeah. Yeah. But there are tons of them, and they look so cute. The eyes are quite big, and it's just like when they look at you, I was like, oh, they are checking us out.
Yeah, so those guys are... Like the puffer fish, the spines are venomous.
Yeah.
And yeah, both of them are highly toxic. The toadfish and the puffer fish.
Oh, the toadfish are as well.
Yes. Highly, highly toxic. So.
No wonder they've got no fear. They just swim around you all the time. They're like.
Yeah. 70 odd minutes.
Oh, yeah. We went underwater.
I don't know what depth did we get to, Maxim?
No, we crossed 10. We didn't reach 11, but definitely crossed 10. I was checking on my computer.
You know, we started today. I had 125 bar in my tanks, and yeah, when we got out, I was at 30 odd, which is still plenty. Like. Because twins have got the double capacity.
Yeah, so that means you have 60.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, actually about 70.
Yes.
So, yeah. 70 bar, so like that's tons to come out of the water with. So, it's pretty happy. Anytime I'm under 100 bar for a 12 coming out of the water, I'm pretty happy.
Pretty happy about it.
Yeah,
no, I think getting better with air consumption is a really good skill to have.
Yeah.
And over the period of time, as you improve your sack rate, that's really nice.
I think you really, like, if you're going to switch to the dry suit, I think you need to have your game 100% because it throws everything out quite a bit. Like, for instance, it was interesting at the start when I came in, we dropped down deep.
Yeah.
All of a sudden I felt the squeeze on the suit, and actually, with the semi-dry, I felt exactly that same squeeze. When we do a deep boat dive, you feel the whole suit sort of prickling into you.
Right.
Exactly the same feeling with this. I felt all of the suit sort of prickling into me. Yeah. I don't know how to explain it better, but yeah, it just added a bit of air.
Yeah.
It was fine.
I get the same feeling, similar feeling, if not the same, when I let the air out of the suit on the surface, you know? Just through the neck. It's just like squishing in because all the air is coming out, and after that it's just I don't really experience anything. But diving with the twins the first time was pretty good.
Yeah.
It's slightly different from diving with a single tank, but not drastically different, just a tiny bit. So if you ever want to switch to the twins, I'd suggest to it. Yeah, you're carrying more air with you.
Yeah. I think, so something I heard from one of our instructors is that the twins mean that if you're taking the weight anyway, so if, for instance, you're taking 4 kilos, why not take 4 kilos and have the air?
Yes.
Versus taking lead weights that you can't do anything with?
Take the extra weight with your cylinder, and that way you have extra air with you.
So how much weight did you have? I think 2?
I had 1 kg with me.
1 kilo?
Yes.
Okay.
And that was fine. I mean, yeah. At the start I was sort of like bit sus, just cause like I'm not used to the twins first time. But I think as I dive more with twins, it's going to be fine.
Yeah, I don't know if you've heard, but there have been some reports of people going down and killing the octopus.
Oh shit.
At Rye.
Oh, at Rye.
Yeah, not here, but at Rye. Look, it doesn't seem like the right thing to do for me anyway.
Well, especially they're intelligent creatures.
They're very, very intelligent, but the reason why they go into these tubes is to put their eggs down. So they're there trying to look after their babies.
Yeah.
So yeah, hopefully these little octopus will grow up to be big. You know what, it's one of those things, there's not a lot of octopus around. Really. Like if you go to most of the places, you don't see huge amounts of octopus.
Yeah.
So I think they're really special and we need to look after them.
Of course.
So a couple of things to be careful of here. Getting in the water is tricky, right?
Yes.
So there's this little area down here. You can come in down the little ladder and walk in. At the moment, it's really high tide. There's also a little ladder that you can jump in on the other side. Like there's a little stainless steel railing and ladder over that side. I have seen people just jump off the edge of the end of this pier here. It's a bit of a long drop. I probably wouldn't do it. I don't really like that idea.
Yeah, I think the safest way definitely is just use this ladder.
Yeah, and there's a nice little hole that you can put your fins in as well when you jump down there. And it's quite easy to reach your fins from the top.
Yes.
So I would just leave all your fins and everything you can up the top, climb down the ladder, and then grab them from the top.
Yes.
When you're coming out, I would always come out in that same spot. There's like a little rocky staircase. Just take it easy going up there, you don't need to rush. It can be a little bit slippery sometimes.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
And there are some rocks that you can get your foot into. So just take it easy. If you need to get on your knees to sort of wobble out a bit, I would do that. Especially with things like twins, the twins I found really hard getting up those. Yeah. I just went, look, I'm gonna just crawl a little bit and then get up on my leg, feet and okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, obviously we said before the other entry is that little metal ladder. You can jump out on that one. That was really good. I've found it a bit squeezy when I've done it before.
Especially when you're with twins, right? Like, yeah. With singles, probably okay. With twins, because it's like a little bit wider, you'd be able to do it, but you know, you've got to be a bit careful.
A bit of practice. Last time, I kind of slipped off it, actually. So, it would have been great to get a video off, but you can either swim up along the pier and then follow the outside of the pier, and you can sort of, once you get past the wall that's attached to the pylons, you can sort of swim in and go around the end of the pier there, that area. That's pretty good.
Very dark pier under there, because you've got the rocks, the breakwater on one side, and you've got the wall on the other. So, yeah, if you don't really like doing the night diving thing, it's basically a night dive under that pier every day.
Yeah.
Another option is to go through that tunnel that we went through.
Head up along the pier, and at the end of where all the boats are, there's like a transition between the rocky outside and the pier pylons. You'll see there's like a pier wall and rocks, and there's a little transition. There's a little pathway that you can get through.
Yeah.
I would recommend going with somebody who's done it before, because it's a bit weird. It feels really enclosed. But if you've got lights on, it's okay. Essentially, what you do is you go in and you follow the pylons, and then you'll see on your left that there's like a little hole going to outside. And it's a much easier thing to do for the first time, definitely, when there's light, because you can see the light coming through.
Yeah.
Hopefully, you'll see Boops explore through the hole. Into the unknown.
Well, let's figure it out.
And then you can either go left or right. So if you go left, you can go down like a little reefy area.
Yeah.
Or you can go to the right, head along. You'll just kind of see a whole lot of boulders. You can check those out. We saw the octopus line that I was really keen to show you.
Yeah.
As you're swimming along past the boulders, there was just a line, a rope line, and you can sort of head along and check out all of the octopus there.
Yeah, there's really sort of like pipes attached after some point on that line, and today most of them had octopus in them.
So from there, I'd head back along the line. We kind of headed off and caught up with another line, and then we kind of just headed a bit further.
And then we were like,
further to the east than we should have. I would head back along the line if I did it again next time, and then go around the end of the pier. Another option though is you can go in through that passageway and then follow the pier all the way out that way. So that's really quite fun to do. It's sort of like a cavey type of area.
And look, there are quite a lot of fish around the pier as well. So you get to see quite a lot of things. So it's not bad.
Yeah. And then obviously when you're heading back, you just head along, follow the pier in. We actually ended up around these buoys over here. And at the bottom there were seahorses. It was quite cool. We just were heading along, and Boops was like, oh yeah, there's a yacht there. I'm like, okay, cool. And then I looked at the rope line, and there's this huge seahorse. It looked like it must have been pregnant.
Yeah.
So yeah, that was amazing, an amazing find.
Obviously come down here if you want to dive. It's a good spot. Yeah. Check the conditions. It gets good visibility.
I'd definitely not come down here if you're a beginner. Like, you really want to have done. I don't know, at least 30 to 50 dives, I would have thought.
Yeah.
Just make sure that you're really settled, because, look, it is a little bit deeper, but there's also lots of fishing line, there's lots of stuff to get caught in, and not everyone's got Boops to save them, so.
Oh, there you go. Yeah. Or we can go dive together.
True.
But yeah, pretty nice spot, check it out. Yeah, that's the other thing. Keep an eye as you are surfacing for boats.
Yeah, quite a lot of boats. And there's some of the commercial fishing boats, so yeah, you don't want to get mucked around with them.
The other thing to keep in mind is there is a breakwater just here. So anywhere there's a breakwater, it's a good idea to be cautious if you start getting swell, because the swell on the breakwater will become a lot bigger.
Yeah.
And if you then surface and you've got the breakwater, breaking waves, extra swell than you would normally get, it'd be nasty. Oh yeah, the parking here is really good. And there's, again, toilets right next to us, so
yeah,
it's a nice little spot.
And there's a cafe and a restaurant.
There is a nice cafe. The only thing is the paid parking is only 2 hours, so
yeah, just make sure that you finish up your dive and everything in 2 hours.
Yep. Next time, I reckon if we both have the twins, we've both got the same amount of air, we're both pretty warm, it should be a really, really good dive.
Yeah. All right.